Hello and welcome! In this video, you will learn how to create the Shadow Priest shader from World of Warcraft using Unity. The effect is composed by two parts. A shader that darkens the character and moves constantly a noise pattern along the vertical axis, and a VU effect that simulates the evil aura around the player. In this video, we will create the shader. Don't miss the second part where we will create the VU effects. To start, we download from SKETCHFAB a beautiful 3D model. We choose Walgin, realized by Sanguinax. The link is available in the description below. Once we have created a new lightweight render pipeline Unity project and imported the model, we create a new PBR shader called Shadowform. We expose two Vector1 parameters to set metallic and smoothness from the editor. Now we take care of the albedo branch. Here we need to darken the troll's texture. To realize it, we just need to add to the starting texture contained in the sample texture 2D node our chosen color. But before doing that, we multiply the color of the main texture for a new exposed float parameter. This will let us choose how much the texture is predominant over the custom color. We return to the editor and we create a material that uses our custom shader. We assign to the main texture field the troll's texture and we start to play with the power value to set how much the custom color prevails on the texture. Now the emission branch. Here we need to create brighter stains that move constantly along the character. We add a time node and we multiply it for a custom float parameter that we call speed. In this way we'll handle the scroll speed. The movement is only vertical and it goes from the bottom to the top of the character. This is why we need to zero the x-axis thanks to a Vector2 node and we use a 1- node to reveal the scroll direction. To complete the movement, we have to indicate what to move. So, we add a tiling and offset node and we link our output to the offset input. The brighter stains are created by a simple noise node. This node is very useful because it creates a random generated grayscale pattern that we can set as we prefer. If all is working correctly, you will see the texture scroll in the preview of the node. We decrease the noise scale to obtain larger and more evident stains. To make the division between the background and stains clearer and adjustable, we add a smooth step node. By setting the edge parameter of this node, we can choose how much details of the pattern maintains. Now we need to color this pattern. Stains will have the same base color, but many of them will have a brighter and emissive color in the center. In the lowest branch, we realize the largest stains, so we set the edge parameter to 0.3 and we add a new color called secondary color. In the upper branch, we create smaller stains by setting the edge value to 0.6 and we use a brighter HDR color. These will be the emissive positions inside the largest stains. Once the two branches have been colored, we merge them. First with a multiply node to blend everything in a single node and then with an add node to obtain back the background that we almost lost during the multiply operation. We link the output to the emissive field of the master node. Now, we only need to play with all the exposed parameters to obtain the most similar result. we have many options to play with. For this video is everything. Hope you enjoyed it. We will continue by creating the evil aria. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and follow us on our social pages. This helps a lot and motivates us to do always new cool contents. See you next time. Bye!